In this series of webcasts, we're going to learn to recognize and classify symmetry within a molecule. Then we're going to put that symmetry to use in order to determine the topic relationships between groups of atoms or between faces within a molecule. Finally, we're going to use symmetry in order to understand and analyze the stereochemical outcome of a reaction that involves the formation of new stereocenters. For example, are there any reactivity differences between these two bases? One of them has a stereocenter and one of them does not. What are the consequences of the stereochemistry on the reactivity of these two molecules? We also might want to know something about the functional groups within a molecule. Can we expect any difference in reactivity between these two hydroxyl groups? The answers to questions like this are going to be found by an analysis of the molecule's symmetry. To extend this example further, consider the Krost-Aldo reaction between acetone and this aldehyde. It's promoted by the base diethylamide. Following enolate formation and addition of the aldehyde, two new products are formed, and they differ only by the configuration at the hydroxyl group. The ratio of products B and C that result could be 1:1, or the two products might be formed in unequal amounts. To answer the question, are B and C going to form in equal amounts, we need to establish a connection between symmetry and reactivity. That connection is going to depend on things like what's the isomeric relationship between the products B and C. In this case, B and C are enantiomers. They'd have equal energy since they're enantiomers, and therefore we might expect that they'd form in equal amounts. But before we completely decide that, we need to take into consideration other factors, such as the symmetry property of A and all of the other reactants that are involved. In this case, both of these reactants are achiral, and so we might again expect no special influence by the reactants. Finally, though, we also need to consider other aspects that make up the chemical environment, such as reagents, this diethyl amide. It's achiral as well, so we don't see any special influence on the stereochemistry from this group. Or the solvent and the catalyst, these things also need to be considered. Any chemical species involved in what's known as the stereodefining step must be taken into consideration. For this reaction, the stereodefining step comes after enolate formation. The stereodefining step is the step in which the newly established stereocenter is created. That would be the AD sub N for this Aldo reaction. In this example, we expect equal amounts of B and C to form. And the reason is, first, because B and C are enantiomers, equal energy. And second, because there is no stereochemical bias by any of the reactants or reagents, solvent or catalyst in the stereodefining step. Therefore, both configurations will form in equal amounts. What about the closely related Krost-Aldo reaction shown here? Will E and F be formed in equal amounts or something else? E and F are diastereomers, so we might expect that they would have different energies, and having different energies, we would expect that they would form in unequal amounts. Where does that bias come from in reactivity? Well, we start with a reactant, D, that already has a stereocenter, and so the enolate resulting from D will end up biasing the stereodetermining step to favor one configuration over the other. In the upcoming webcast, we're going to develop the tools of molecular symmetry to analyze reactions in which multiple stereoisomeric products are involved, thereby establishing the connection between symmetry and reactivity.